Welcome to the Nerd Lore Podcast. We talk stories, theories, and lore. I'm one of your three hosts, Shiny Shoes.
And I'm Crashstarling.
And I'm the Real Skandle.
Are you sure?
Yeah, it doesn't sound like him. So today we're gonna be diving into a little bit of culture of the unknown, space, aliens, other things like that. We're gonna talk about some things that we find interesting about that whole aspect of our culture, really. Crash is going to take it away.
Okay, so the first thing that I noticed about how aliens are depicted is there's one of two archetypes. They're both humanoid, first of all. The second thing is that they're either really smart and they lose a lot of their human-like features, like the body hair, they get engrossed heads. They basically look like small humans with, like, bigger heads and no genitalia. The second one is the warrior, which they're usually like super high tech,
big predator
for human. Yes.
Yeah. Exactly.
Those come mostly from what I've seen from like movies and then like folklore. But I want to say, is there any archetype, any like type of alien that for you just surpasses all the others, either for a good reason or for a bad reason?
So I did just bring up Predator, and when I was younger, I didn't care about the Predator movies. When I got into high school, it kind of became a running joke between me and my friends. We'd always be like, who could win between this person and Predator? That was just a running joke between us, and we'd take car rides and we would argue who would win. We had one friend that always argued on the side of Predator, and then you just had to battle Predator, basically. Like, we would do Jesus versus Predator, Kevin from Home Alone versus Predator. Yeah, that's what we always, like, goofy stuff like that. We'd always talk about it. So I didn't really get into it. Then I remember, like, the first Alien versus Predator movie, and I went and watched that, and I'm like, okay, this is kind of cool. Like, two different species, two ways that cinema has put forth aliens to us, and the Predator one's kind of like a smart killer. Well, I'm not going to say that I became like a biggest fan, but I did go watch the movies. Like, I would start watching the movies. The latest Predator movie actually brought Predator lore into the, like, series. So basically, these Predators, they were sending their people off to fight to gain, like, the best skills of all the people that they're conquering. So, like, they would send them to Earth so that they can assimilate with us humans and gain our best skills. So, like, our ability to reason and stuff like that. And I thought that was really neat. I'm probably butchering, like, exactly what it was, because, again, it was a Predator movie, and I'm not saying, like, every plot point was covered very well. But I was like, oh, it makes sense why the Predators are coming and hunting everybody. Oh, they got Predator dog now. That's cool. It's a good dog. So, good Predator boy. So, that I thought that was pretty neat. And then with them rebooting all the Alien movies, which, awesome.
Yeah.
Those are actually good movies. Whereas the Predator, that you're just going to see him punch things. I can get down on that. I guess I would say that's mine.
I liked the Alien version better. I liked the... That was hands down one of the scariest movies I had ever seen as a kid. The fact that the thing came from her stomach, and then all the jump scares, because jump scares weren't as big of a thing back then as they were, as they are now. Like, every horror movie is nothing but jump scares nowadays, and I don't like that, so I don't watch them. My daughter hates that because I don't watch the new horror movies, because I don't like jump scares, man. Like, I like the sophisticated. So I think that's why I like the Aliens. It was a different type of terror. Predator was in your face, like
action movie.
Yeah, it was a Schwarzenegger movie. You know what I mean? Like, it's an action movie, and I kind of associate him with like the other who the dude who played Rocky, like all
Sylvester Stallone. Yeah,
yeah,
they're both
the Sly. You, it all came from, like, none of those movies have, like, a great storyline, right? There's a lot of action.
I'm not there for that. Listen, I just want somebody to get on a chain gun and.
But the aliens, I liked the way that they did things, the story behind it. Who, you know, the mother of them all, I loved watching those movies, but hated watching those movies, and I think it really warped my perception on aliens in general. Like, I just always associate them with being evil.
Have you guys met anyone that hasn't liked the Alien reboots?
I haven't seen them. I need to watch them.
I haven't seen them either.
I'd recommend them. Like, everybody, all of my friend group that is watching them is just like, wow, this is really good, and it goes like the backstory of the aliens, and you figure out how they work and why.
You guys ever think about, like, the fact that our basis of aliens is just, like, kind of projecting a human ego? The aliens are either, like, stronger than us physically, or they're smarter than us mentally. Like, there's no in between. It's basically just us, but slightly better in one angle. That's why we're so scared of them.
I like that idea. I like that theory. But no, I don't think so. I think when writers write about aliens, like, in the sense you're trying to make it out to be, because it's typically what they do, is they're assuming that if the aliens were able to make it to our world, right, to Earth, that technologically wise, they're way more advanced than we are, right? So because of that, they probably have technological advancements in, say, like, strength, you know, or just because they're aliens and they have different attributes. It does, I don't know, but, like, there's a thought behind this whole. But I don't know, man. Like, I feel like I'm being weird now. The way you guys
it's good. I mean, if you think about it, like, the way things are going, when we finally roll up on somebody else's planet, like. What are they going to see us as? Because, like, I mean, humans, just in general, kind of a-holes. Like, if we roll up on somebody's planet, you're like, oh, you got some nice water there. We need water. Well, obviously, we're going to try to take some of that.
We're going to be interstellar Christopher Columbus. I claim this land mine, but I already live here. Oh, I already called the guys.
So yeah. Here. Oh, you live here? I've got some blankets. You can have to stay warm.
Can I ask a question to go on here, or can I interrupt your time?
I'm sorry, I'm in shock just now.
So I just want to ask a question, but I don't want to interrupt you in your time. So, because this question may it. Like,
oh, it's good.
Our conversation. Go for it. Okay, so. Because we all know from the past episodes that you guys have watched or listened, I kind of have, like, a dark affiliation to games. Like all my games are, you know, they're about demons, or that's just
kind of edgy. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I guess I'm an edgelord. I guess that's what that means to me. That term is new to me. So, now I know that's going to get clipped. So I'm an edgelord. So anyway, because we're talking about how whenever we get advanced enough, we'd be able to go to another planet, right? And maybe there's life there. And so they look at us as aliens, obviously, because we're from another planet. Do you think maybe, just kind of a weird question, is it possible that the aliens already have come to Earth, and that's who we see as angels and demons?
That's a whole episode on itself.
Let's do it.
So that's what the game Doom is kind of based upon. Like, if you look at it, the people in Doom, the demons or whatever they are, the aliens, they, and maybe I'm butchering it, but this is my understanding of the lore. They came to Earth and were, like, all around and they set up these little obelisks all around, these little, like, teleportation portal type things, and were just basically waiting until we are technologically advanced enough to come to their dimension. There are a lot of religions that believe that. And it can be its whole, again, a whole episode on its own. But there's a specific one that I had a friend that was kind of into. It was called the Raelion Movement. And that was a thought process. Aliens brought knowledge here. They came to us, brought this knowledge, then left to go do the same elsewhere. And we as humans weren't fulfilling up to our destiny because our job wasn't to, like, make commerce and stuff like that. Our job was to take the advancements and continue to use that to better our lives, but our time was spent to learn how to make what they gave us better, so to out advance them. So the religion is founded upon we shouldn't be spending our days working, we should be spending our days learning and trying to better society as a whole.
All right, you calm. Okay.
And then I'll wait for my other one. Let's go.
Wait, I was gonna throw out mine. So I think it'd be amazing, interesting, if like ancient gods were actually just aliens with superpowers. Like if Zeus was just an alien, that'd be amazing. But then I thought, wow, that's a whole lot of nasty things that aliens did to us, Zeus.
Oh. Looking at you, Zeus.
Yeah, looking at you, Zeus. But it would be like you'd have to think about the gods are going to depend on a lot of things, but most of them rely on like what we see and understand. So maybe we're just misinterpreting like crazy technology that we didn't have any concept of. Maybe. But at the same time, maybe we just like telling cool stories.
Mm. Like cool stories.
I do like cool stories and theories. And lore.
Wow.
NerdLore podcast. Yeah.
Yeah. I like the talk about the technology piece though, because there's this article that was published recently, and it was a lady, and she was talking to one of her colleagues, and they're having a conversation of which one is cooler, technology or magic. And the first colleague's like, well, magic's cooler, obviously. And the lady that was rebelling went this whole thing about how technology is magic. Mm-hmm. And she's like, the first lady's like, well, I can, you know, do that. I pull a rabbit out of a hat and I can shoot fire out of my hands. And the lady's like, listen, I can take a piece of plastic, I can give it to you, and that plastic can create fire. Just because I put stuff in it that makes it make fire. What is more magic than that? Technology. I read the whole thing. It was really interesting. Technology.
I thought you're talking about showmanship magic.
Yeah, and
see someone throw a lightning bolt.
Lightning bolt.
Lightning bolt.
That's pretty cool.
I cast Bane.
Did you have a second one? Crash?
I never answered what my cool.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. I got.
Oh shit, no, dude. No, I'm so sorry.
Yeah, we got talking, and you know.
Okay. I came back to you because I just really want to take a dump on No Man's Sky.
That makes sense. That makes sense.
If you don't know what No Man's Sky is, bless your sweetheart. No Man's Sky was a like the space engineering game that we had been waiting for years. It had 80 quintillion bedillion planets and endless expanses to explore. And they were like, you know what? Just to make it super cool, we're going to throw in an alien generator. It's going to randomly generate these really interesting creatures. And man, I didn't know that one whole video game could ruin aliens and dinosaurs for me, because that's literally what they did, was just mash as many dinosaur pieces they could together and just like, here's the alien, take care of him now. I hate No Man's Sky. I heard it's better, but I just really wanted to say that is the worst thing I've ever seen anyone do. How could you ruin aliens and dinosaurs for me?
But what was your favorite one?
What's your favorite
archetype?
What's my favorite archetype?
There was obviously none in No Man's Sky. There was zero there.
No. I don't know. I kind of like how, like, I was going to say anime, but then I was like, never mind. Because anime is just, oh, that object, that thing, that whatever over there is, it's now a girl. It's a hot girl with big bazongas.
Yeah.
But I can't think of like a favorite. That's the issue. is that...
Is there one that resonates? Like, if I said, hey, Crash, there's an alien, what do you see?
Vel'Koz. It's literally like the when they attack, because he's just not humanoid.
Yeah.
It's the most alien thing I can think of.
Oh, okay. That's fair. That's fair.
If you said aliens, I'd either say, like, an octopus or, like, they got some crazy shrimp out there that can punch so hard it makes fire. That sounds pretty alien to me.
That'd be, yeah. I'd subscribe to that.
Okay.
So, did you have a second topic, or did you want me to continue off mine?
Go for yours.
All right, cool.
Got the green light.
So, I want to kind of dive into reported alien stories. Things that people have said that they have encountered. And I spent a lot of time at work for the past week. After I figured out, I texted them, I was like, hey, we're doing aliens, right? Really going into which one of these, one of them sounds more like a hoax, the other one sounds more realistic. But, you know, like, there's a bunch of online websites and they'll say, hey, you know, we have aliens, yada, 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 go on and go forth from unclassified files that have been collected. But none of them are definitive, like, hey, this happened. But there are a couple stories out there that are backed up by, you know, what has been seen by military bases, eyewitness reports from multiple individuals, not just a single person. But I was like, well, let's look at some of those. So I came to two of them. The first one was the Kelly Hopkinsville encounter.
Is that in Tennessee or Kentucky?
It is. Yeah. It was in Kentucky.
Yeah.
So it was a close encounter with extraterrestrial beings. And what basically ended up happening here, there was a family at a farm in Kentucky. And these individuals went to the cops after what they claimed was hours of them shooting at aliens that were trying to peek in the windows of their porch. So the police were like, yo, these people are in a gunfight with their neighbors probably. We're going to go check it out. So they go and check it out. Now, there wasn't a lot of information that it was aliens. They were like, hey, you know, we're not seeing the same thing you are. They found a little bit of, like, a green goo next to a fence line. But other than that, like, they found some, like, not necessarily footprints, but it looked like someone had been moving through the woods. That's it. That's all they found. So the cops eventually, like, the Air Force was there. The Air Force said it was inconclusive. A lot of people just like, okay, nothing happened. So they leave. The next morning, they come back and the family is gone. And the neighbors said that the family left. And it was said that because the creatures had come back at 3 a.m, terrorizing again. So this one is kind of widely debated. The most logical explanation is there are these owls. So giant horned owls from Kentucky that have yellow glowing eyes in the dark, they're known to aggressively protect their nests. So the theory is that these owls were continuously attacking these farmers because they felt threatened. That is how everyone explained off the incident. Maybe that's true, maybe not. I don't 100% know because I wasn't there, and it was 70 years ago now, 1955.
70 years ago. Well, 65 years. No, it is 70 years ago.
That's like it's close to 70, right? Or maybe it is.
So they never found bodies?
They didn't find bodies or nothing. Again, there are a lot of different reports of this online. So I read through a lot of pages. Some pages said that they had found evidence of something happening in the creek bed. On that night, it was documented that there was a meteor shower. That's a widely known fact. That happened that night. There was a meteor shower. The family said that something streaked down near their house into the creek bed. That's what the family had said. And then they were claiming that it consistently attacked them. Now, the family was kind of, a lot of people didn't believe them because they weren't necessarily a high standing family. They had two of the family members that had worked in the circus, basically. we don't know necessarily what happened, but it is widely assumed that this one was a hoax. But they said that there's no way to prove that this didn't happen to these individuals, and it something definitely happened, because the story between all the individuals, all five of the people in the house, was so closely corroborated that they know something happened, and the only way they can explain it is giant horned owls.
Huh.
That's still pretty creepy.
It is. I mean, I guess owls are mean sometimes. I don't know. But they were coming in. They're coming in hot.
This is like in Kentucky, though, right? Like, there's not. Are there birds of prey? Like big? Like, I mean, like, that would pick bones? Like, vultures there? Vultures wouldn't be there, right?
No, no vultures. But there are giant horned owls. And they said they can be.
Bone?
No.
That's what I'm trying to say is, like, they didn't find any bodies or anything.
Yeah, and if you're shooting, you think about it, if you're shooting a shotgun out a window and a bird that's peeking in, birds aren't that fast. Like,
yeah, why? It's dark, and it's an owl.
But it's a shotgun.
Yeah, I mean, it's not like it's going to get away, but I'm saying, like, if the birds, like, if they're trying to explain this by saying, like, oh, the meteor fell in the creek bed and the birds were like, oh, God.
Yeah, the birds were, yeah.
I'd be like, I mean, I could see it. I could see the birds attacking, but I don't understand, like, wouldn't they find a bird carcass?
You would think. They said the entire, like, so the door and all the windows were just pelted with shotgun pellets. Or whatever they used back then. Probably wasn't something as, like, as what we would know now.
Jesus Christ, they're not shooting musket balls, bud.
Taste cannon, alien! Yes. So, that's what they found. The entire front, like, the front side of the house was shot up from the inside out. It's hard to explain.
Family acid trip gone wrong.
Yeah, that's a possibility. But they had all had the same bad trip. That's the crazy part. There's a lot going on there. Yeah, I know. It's weird, isn't it?
Hysteria makes you believe, like, whatever your senses tell you.
Yeah.
So if you're like, I don't know about owls, but if they, like, if some guy happened to be in, like, their window.
Oh, yeah.
And, like, ducked off to the side, and then all these birds, like, say a guy was in their window, then the meteor shower hit. He freaks out thinking, oh God, these people have a cannon. Starts running away. Then all the birds are like freaking out. And then, I don't know, maybe like that. And maybe the neighbor was just a little close to the house.
Yeah. There's so much going on there to explain it as just birds. But that's the agreed upon explanation was it's birds. Just weird. So that's the first one. The second one is the Shag Harbor UFO incident. Hell yeah, Shag.
Yeah, I was like, take me a trip to Shag Harbor.
So, Shag Harbor, basically, there were a lot of individuals who were saying around 10 p.m. that night, they saw all these yellow lights in the sky. Around the same time, there was a flight going on, Air Canada 305. And Air Canada 305 radios into the tower. They said, hey, there's like a cube-looking object in the sky, a couple miles from us, flying and matching our pace. And then there was an explosion. The object began to descend. Around the same time, a bunch of people who live in Shag Harbor are calling in to their local authorities saying, hey, something is bright. It came out of the sky and it landed in the harbor. So a bunch of people, a couple families that lived there were sitting out on the porch when that happened. There were people in the town that had said something about it. Within an hour, boats from the dock there had got enough people. They had originally thought it was a plane that crashed. So they're getting on the line and they're calling all the air traffic controller people. And they're like, hey, did a plane go down? What's going on? Well, it was confirmed the next morning that not a single plane was unaccounted for. So they sent a search team out. By the time when the people started getting on boats heading out, they said that the item that was floating in the water begin to sink. And before they got to it, it had completely submerged itself underwater. Well, they spent a long time that night looking for it. Didn't find nothing. So the next day, the Navy sent out divers. The divers spent 2 days searching the bottom of the harbor, looking for anything that could have been there. Then, out of nowhere, all the divers come up. They go to shore. They said, you know what? We're calling it off. We can't find nothing. And the military gets in a vehicle and leaves. There were a lot of people in the town who all corroborated the same thing. People that lived nowhere near each other saw the same object come from the sky, hit the water, stay there with bright yellow lights, and then submerge. The military says they have no idea but would like to know what happened. It is still classified as a technical UFO, unidentified flying object. Still to this day, there's no official report of what it was or if they ever actually found it.
Sky Daddy dropped his D6.
Chapow!
Boom. Mystery solved.
This was in Nova Scotia. There's a lot to it. But as you go, you kind of look through all of it. A lot of it has some files, but there is a monument of where it's at, saying, hey, this is where the Shag Harbor Museum is, and this is where the UFO landed. Huh. So, again, you had a lot of eyewitnesses from different areas saying something happened, but nobody's able to figure out exactly what happened there.
I really don't know. There's not enough information for me.
There is enough for anyone. Now, I'm not saying that there was aliens. I'm not saying it happened.
Conspiracy theory? Are they trying to say that they found something and took it with them and have kept it a secret?
There isn't enough out about it. Like, the people that were there aren't saying anything. They just, all I'm given is what reports are. Now, if you look into it, you go deeper in, there are people thinking that they found something, and we're just not sharing it. But again, that's more on the government conspiracy side. I'm just talking, you know, what kind of alien things do we think we've seen? And if you really start looking into it, there's a lot of times when a large group of individuals will report seeing weird displays of lights and stuff. And there's the Jersey Turnpike incident. That's a good one if you ever feel like looking into something like that. There's a couple of them in Texas, Roswell. A lot of really neat stuff when you start digging, but there's still, as I was saying when I started, nothing that pins this down. Like, hey, this was an actual alien encounter. And you would think, so many people seeing so many things, nothing's ever pinned down. It's like pictures of Bigfoot.
Well, I'm pretty sure that picture of Bigfoot's been debunked.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know about that. Well, like, I think one thing that might be a factor in this, like, strange light happenings is the fact that, I mean, if most of these places probably live in a fairly modern society, they at least have, like, let's say electricity,
mm-hmm.
right? So if these places are surrounded by electricity, that causes a lot of light pollution. Like, if you go out to places where there's no light during the nighttime, the sky is completely different.
Oh, yeah.
So, I mean, maybe that's a factor. Maybe. Yeah.
They can see more than we can't. Yeah. Talking about, like, the light pollution, me and my wife had a whole conversation about that. She's lived in a city. Well, I say city, but it's more like a suburb. She's lived in a place around people her entire life. Then she came out to where I kind of grew up, which was boonies, country. And we got out of the car one night, and we were walking up to a friend's house, and she looked up, and she's like,
oh, wow.
Like, what? Yeah. That's what the sky looks like? And I'm like, yeah, there's no light out here. Nothing is keeping you from seeing that.
And that's when Shiny turned to her and said, it's beautiful. Just like you.
Yeah, got her.
And then got her. Yeah, exactly. You got her. You landed her. Hey.
So those are the two that I really want to get into. Because out of all of them, so there's a lot of the stories. But those are two well-documented ones that have flaky explanations at best that a lot of people really look into. There's a bunch more. If you feel like spending your entire day down rabbit holes, there are tons of them you can go down, but those two are really interesting to me.
Like, I don't know if I feel like I'd recognize a bird outside my window when I saw one.
And how many would there have had to been? Because they said they were attacked by multiple of those creatures. And they described them as like little men with horns. And they said they didn't call them green men. But later on, the newspaper that reported it picked that up and started saying it. But that isn't what the people who witnessed it had said. They just said they were little guys with claws. Kind of horn-like on the top of their head with big eyes.
Yeah, I mean, I believe the bird thing then. I mean, if you're in the dark and it hits like one contrasting angle, feathers are definitely going to look sharper.
Want to know a fun fact about that, though?
What's up?
So, fun fact about the Kentucky alien sighting, Pokemon Sableye is based upon their explanation of what they saw.
Like, it's like the man, like it's like a caricature. Yeah. That's a Pokemon. I'm into it.
Yeah, it's based off of that alien experience. Sableye is. So, just fun fact for everybody out there. I know you like that Skandle.
I do.
He really loves it when we bring up Pokemon.
Oh, I know. It's his favorite.
It's joy on his face.
It just makes me feel so old because like, I didn't get into it. I don't know. It's like Dragon Ball Z. I was older whenever that came out, and so I didn't get into that either.
Will Skandle enjoy Dragon Ball Z? Find out next time.
Dragon Balls.
All right, what did you get for Skandle?
I already asked the question I was going to ask because it just seemed like the perfect time to ask it when we got on.
Came in there.
I mean, the only other thing I could say, because this is what kind of brought me to think about that, is my daughter has been watching all of the Marvel movies with us because she's never wanted to, but now... She's watching now that we have them on Disney Plus, and we just finished Endgame, and so we only have Far From Home left as far as movies wise to watch together. But when I was watching the end of the movie, I started thinking about this topic tonight. And there's a spot in the end of the movie where Thor is standing there with Valkyrie, and they're looking over the little town that's full of their people, right? And it got me wondering, could it be that a lot of, and again, we already asked this question, we kind of delved into it, but the religious, the messiahs, these holy figures that have come down, could they not just be aliens? Like say Thor, right? Comes down and now these people have a whole history because he sat down and talked about his home and, you know, where Valhalla is and all this, like he talked now, these Vikings, these, you know, this whole group of people have this story and now this religion that they follow unbelievably close because of, you know, this being or whatever that showed up. It could be the same thing with Jesus or, you know what I mean?
Like, I'm with it.
Credit religion here. I'm trying to like incorporate a question like, what do you think about those kind of things? Like, did Jesus, when he died, was that his way of leaving Earth because he had learned everything he learned? So he, you know, God himself crucified. And when he rose from the dead 3 days later, was that his like drop mic, drop curtain call kind of thing?
You know? Hey, I'm out.
That's where my brain goes. Like, I was watching that movie and that's what I was.
That brings up an interesting point, is that if Jesus was an alien, that would mean that he came from another planet and we told him about our God. And he was like, yeah, I likes that.
He's like, that's good. I'm his son, actually.
He was like the world's greatest like extraterrestrial con artist. Where he's like, oh, God, that's me.
Think about it this way. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off.
You're good.
Right? Think about it this way. God had visited many, 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 many centuries before Jesus. And so all these people who created the Old Testament to talk about this God was actually an alien that had gone here way back in the day. And then they started writing this religion about him and they were offering sacrifices and doing all this stuff to their God. And then his son or whatever revisited Earth because his father has talked about it for so much through his, you know, years of growing up that he had to come see it for himself. And so then he came down, and this is the story he kind of did up for his people. You know what I mean? For the people who asked questions. I'm just this is just shit coming off the top of my head.
It's a lot, and it's a lot to think into when you go into that piece. Like, hey, you know, what is going on? Like, what actually happened? That's the best thing when you kind of look into that, the whole alien thing and the whole topic. There is nothing definitive on what happened, so it's really up to imagination. You let people's imagination run wild, you get great things. So.
And maybe the second coming of Christ is actually Jesus's kid, God's grandson, that is supposed to come visit.
With his Starfleet.
To take us all away.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
That's the rapture.
I know, right? That's what I'm saying. That's, when he comes back a third time, they're going to just bring all the, because they missed all the entertainment that they had from their visits. They want all of people, instead of coming to Earth and living, they have to go back home. So they're going to. People
yeah, I mean, I like it.
Or just the ones he thinks are cool.
I'm in then, boys. We did it. So, that was our kind of look through at aliens and some of the theories and stuff that we've kind of been drawn to throughout our lifetimes. So, what kind of things do you know about aliens? What kind of things you want to talk about? Are there any alien stories that specifically you latch onto as a human? What do you think of when you hear aliens? Let us know in the comments. Kind of get at us. And if you want to come on here and talk to us about aliens, I don't see why not. So this has been NerdLore, signing out.